Hey yo everyone, today I'm going to show you how to reball or replace the turtle egg, which responds for the home sensor function. I have attached the home sensor to a metallic plate on with jeans, with a piece of jeans, with some magnets holding it to the metallic plate, so it does not move when I'm working on it. This touch it seems from a dropped device because the egg is cracked in corner. So this is a sign of dropped device. I have buy it along with a logic board which is on iCloud locket. I did not test it, the touch functions before doing this work. So first step is the cleaning of the white transparent glue using 100 of them. Full airflow to blow the removed glue away from the display that I am cleaning. Also, the video is 4x speed to watch it faster because slow is boring. After the cleaning, I'm going to remove this egg using soldering iron on top with some solder. The soldering iron have 300 of temp. As you can see, no need special tools. Now I'm going to clean with soldering iron the old solder from factory, which is harder. Which melt harder than the one I have because it have other alloys. Also, I don't recommend cleaning here using the copper braid wick because as you can see, I am doing some small cleanings and the cutting is removing and the copper is exposed. And when you will use that copper braid wick, you can remove a lot more than what you have seen in my video. I'm not sure why I have cleaners here, I don't remember. Now I am going to reball the egg without any stencil behind reball. You already know this method. So this whole video is made of two videos. Now you are watching the first video, which is reballing the turtle egg. In case if it's good on your touch, it flex. In the second video, I'm going to show how I will replace it with a new one. Also, I wanted to cut this part of the video because I wanted to make it one whole video on replacing the turtle egg. Then I have decided that I will still include this part and show that to reball it is also possible and it's not needed to replace if the egg is in good condition. Now I am going to cover this exposed copper with some solder mask. Here I also must be careful to not add too much how I added, as you can see on the solder pad. Ultraviolet to dry the solder mask. A little of the flux to stick the egg in its place. looking if it's on all its parts, aligned and heating. So after some time, I have decided to replace this cracked egg with a new one. I only wanted to show that you can rebuild the egg if it's in good condition, if device was dropped. And there is called solder. You can rebuild just without replacing. But if you have a cracked egg, like in my case, you will have to replace with a new one. And I have buried gently and decided to replace. The part number is not fully the same, but I hope it will work. Because the difference in part number is at the end. Of it. Okay, here we can see this new egg is 1ACBZ, but the old egg, oh, I have thrown it. It has the old original egg have 2ACBZ, but I think this is not very important. The most important is this number here. AD7149. So I am going to hit it to see how the new balls melt. If they melt hard, I am going to rebuild with my own solder by hand. If not, I will sort solder as is. I think the solder is hard. It's not the one that I have expected. Or I did not give enough heat. Well, I'm going to rebuild it with my own solder. We'll have to wait soldering iron to heat to the needed temp. I will clean the old solder balls. Just like that. We'll clean the soldering iron. on that sheet of solder and apply my caster solder ring wire with core rosin, which is the best that I am using from all the time. So before 100 volt, the ink must be cleaned from the flux, because they will not make the pyramid shape. Now we stick to the holder that I am the one who invented it. When my brother was teaching me, he was holding with tweezers, but I have made this holder special for the job. And I can say I have improved this method. The iron tip is not prepared for this, for the hand ball. That's why it's so hard to make them. Takes time. So I will try to melt with the same temp, 180 of temp, and we'll see if the problem was the solder from China. As we can see, oh my fucking gosh, what the fuck I did? I hope it did not melt it, fucking shit. Oh, I am lucky. it did not fuck it short it, shit of the balls of the ship of the egg. Сука, нахуй, блядь. Гандон, шайбаная. Okay, so the soldier from China was shit. As you can see, they melted at the temp that I used. Now I am adding a little of flux and heat a little. So the ink will stick to this look. Now I will fix the ink. I call it Home Sensor ink, but the coded name from Apple is Turtle ink. Now I will take off these magnets that so I will look from the sides, which is also my method to look from the sides. The ink is not aligned. Now we will align it. Okay, I hope now it's alive not. No, it's not alive not. I want to make it perfect. Сука, длинка схема, блядь. If Apple did not make some fucking markings like Samsung making corners, and I was thinking to write them fucking shit. It's so fucking hard to make some markings from factory. Of course they are not interested that people repair their devices. Or technicians. They are making it complicated. Okay, now the ink is aligned. Or it looks like. So I'm going to give 190 of Celsius of temp and full air. I hope I'll feel this fine. Okay, the ink has melted in its place. I will do some cleaning. To see how the balls have melted. I think it looks fine. camera video of the same home FTX because it have a cut, a small cut, and I will fix it in another video, then I will test it at the end. That's it, people. Follow up on the second part of this video. Thanks for watching.